September 10th. I'm Tisha Hines. Good morning. In our top story, Invest Barbados will be on the road for another trade mission as part of a win-win arrangement. This business community in Barbados is invited to join to share immediate and pending investment and expansion opportunities in Miami. The timing of the mission is well aligned as it coincides with the Florida Trade and Cultural Expo that attracts the world and also with the annual MedWeek Conference. Renata Mohammed, Director of Investment and Marketing at Invest Barbados, says that through the Consulate General's office in Miami, they have met the leadership of the Miami-Dade Beacon Council, the Coral Gables Chamber of Commerce, and Broward County. The mission runs from October 1st to 6th. Joining us live is Ms. Mohammed. Good morning to you.
Hi, good morning, Barbados, and good morning from Ottawa, Canada, where we're actually here to attend a risk management conference. But while in Ottawa, my mind is on our mission to Florida, and this is specifically a business mission to the Miami-Dade County and the city of Florida. As you would appreciate, as a national investment promotion agency of the government of Barbados, we are mandated to attract foreign direct investment. As part of that mandate, it leads to job creation. And there are so many methods by which we do that. We advertise, we attend events as we are doing right now in Ottawa, but we also host missions. And these are business missions that are either inward or outward. This year, we would have had missions to Barbados from places like Charleston, Rwanda. We're preparing for Scotland, and we've had Ghana. Outward missions so far for the year included Charleston and Atlanta, and now we are focused on Florida.
And that's excellent. So the big question then is, why Florida at this particular point in time? So why do you decide on them and why now?
Thank you so much. You would think that we know Florida. It's near to us. So many of us travel there. But similarly, persons think they know Barbados. And when they deep dive, they realize the wealth of investment opportunities that exist. So it's meant to be an exploration for the Barbados business community, as well as to provide the Florida business community with an opportunity to get to know us better. We have been in contact through the CG's office in Miami with our various hosts, and collectively we have identified some very specific sectors that are hot, that are exciting, and they're interested in right now. And those include things like fintech, insurance, real estate, manufacturing, and of course it's Florida. It's the interest of the trade of goods and services. And it will be remiss of me not to mention that this mission is being hosted in conjunction with Export Barbados, our sister agency. And the timing, as you mentioned, is so right. We start off with two business forums, one in Miami-Dade and the other in Coral Gables. And this is meant to give each other an appreciation of what we bring to the table. Then we attend the Florida International Trade and Cultural Expo, a very tight agenda, speaking opportunities, networking opportunities, matchmaking will be done. And of course, we assist by providing facilitation services to our people free of charge. And we end off with what's called the MedWeek event. And MedWeek is minority business oriented to our small to medium-sized businesses who are poised for expansion to the U.S., perhaps through Florida, or who have business and investment opportunities in Barbados and are looking for partner investors. They have an opportunity to pitch to persons. So my real extension this morning is an invitation to members of the Barbados business community who would like to join us on this business mission to Florida from October the 2nd to the 6th.
Of course, that was my next question. Who can join in the mission and how they can go about getting involved?
Simply drop us a line. It's rsvp@investbarbados.org. Again, rsvp@investbarbados.org. And the additional information will be provided. But as we do for every mission, Special rates have been negotiated for accommodation. We provide the ground transportation and we manage the agenda on behalf of our delegates. So it's a really great opportunity to enter Florida, potentially enter the US as part of an official mission. And there's so many success stories that we have from delegates who've attended past missions with us that we would like the business community to add to those success stories.
I know that you said that some of the main sectors you're looking at are specifically fintech and insurance, finance, things of that nature. Have you gotten any indicator? I know you said they're hot right now, that you know they can balance out well in this part of the region based on what's happening in the, across the U.S.?
Absolutely. Persons and potential investors remain interested in a stable environment. We offer that in a world that's full of upheaval. In terms of proximity, Florida, the Caribbean, they look to Barbados as a gateway to the rest of the Caribbean, the EC in particular, as well as Latin America. And of course, our Barbadian business community looks to Florida as a gateway to the USA. So we see this mission as really a conduit to win-win collaborations. It's meant to be a deeper exploration. We're meeting our hosts at a very high level. They have been doing a great job in rallying their membership. So instead of you having to do it on your own, please utilize this mission that we are facilitating to make those connections and to further explore the possibilities.
Well, sounds like it's going to be a packed 5 days and two events, so a packed agenda. Wishing you, of course, the very best, and we look forward to hearing only positive things coming out of this mission.
Thank you so very much.
Thank you so much. Coming up on the CBC Morning Report, the rescue effort is still on in Morocco after thousands died and thousands more are injured in the weekend's earthquake.
The summer holiday is almost over, but are you back to school ready? Get back to school ready with Mornin Barbados and get a chance to win a back to school bundle, including a printer, a tablet, and headphones, just in time for the new school year. The Mornin Barbados Are You Back to School Ready promotion starts August 31st until September 13th. If you're between the ages of 8 to 15, all you have to do is tune in to Mornin Barbados and listen for when we ask, are you back to school ready? Call us at 228-5562 or 228-5563. Answer three questions correctly and your name goes forward to the final draw. Remember, callers must be between the ages of 8 and 15. The winner will be announced on September 14th.
Are you a youth group, 4-H club, school, Cub Scout, or Brownie Pack, or any organization or club with children ages 4 to 11 years? If yes, is
Morocco has stepped up efforts to find survivors of Friday's devastating earthquake, with a particular focus on reaching some of the more remote areas of the Atlas Mountains amid reports of flattened villages. The first foreign rescuers flew in to help after the North African country's strongest ever quake killed at least 2,122 people and injured more than 2,400, according to official figures updated late on Sunday.
The village of Asni lies forlorn and in ruins. Its mud, brick, stone and wood buildings no match for Friday's earthquake. One of many such communities in the Al Haouz region, close to the epicentre in the southwest of Morocco. Barely a structure remains untouched. It is here in the high Atlas Mountains that the earthquake has been most devastating and deadly.
There are a lot of blocked roads, a lot of people can't find their parents, and a lot of people are still under the rubble. People are still searching for their relatives. Everything went down on them. The mountains, their homes, you can't really go through. They are still clearing the roads.
As frantic efforts continue in a race against time to find survivors, for some it is too late. In the village of Moulay Brahim, Hussein Adne collects basic supplies for his family in what remains of his home. Nearby, he recalls neighbours who did not survive.
There are still people buried here in this house. They didn't get the rescue they needed, so they died. I rescued my children, and I'm trying to get covers for them and anything to wear from the house.
Funerals take place in the searing late summer heat. Where necessary, mass graves are being prepared. For rescue and relief efforts, this is a challenging area to reach. Windy mountain roads are strewn with boulders, in some places made impassable by rock falls.
Most casualty that we experience are in the mountain area. And as you know, the mountain area is not very accessible. And people are living atop in the mountains. The government are making all what it can to rescue the people, but it is very difficult to reach out to them. Since the winter season is about to start, people have lost their houses. We need all support to be coordinated in order to help this population.
Amid criticism on social media that the government should be allowing more foreign help in, a formal request for international assistance has finally gone out more than 36 hours later, and experienced search and rescue teams initially from Spain are on their way. Complaints here too about the lack of a formal government response to help people living rough in city squares in Marrakesh.
After a night sleeping in the open air, the stoicism of those who say that all this was God's will is turning to anger. A crowd protesting that the government should be doing more to help them. The centuries-old market city of Marrakesh has been spared the worst of this disaster, but here too, in the ancient alleyways of the Medina, homes and shops are damaged, lives and livelihoods upended, and tempers on edge.
Well, several measures are being rolled out by Guyana's government in a bid to prevent malaria infection. We hear more in these efforts from DPI Television.
With dengue cases on the decline, Minister of Health Dr. Frank Anthony has assured that measures are being undertaken to prevent against other vector-borne diseases such as malaria.
Generally, where we see malaria cases is more in regions 1, 7, 8, and 9. And we haven't noted any kind of drastic increase because we have been distributing bed nets and things like that to those communities.
In addition to the distribution of insecticide impregnated bed nets, a continuous training program is being rolled out to tackle malaria in remote mining communities in Guyana. Miners are being trained to conduct malaria rapid tests as they can detect cases in the mining camps.
We also give them medication and train them how to dispense the medication. So if you diagnose, let's say, Vivax malaria, then there are these types of medication. On the envelope itself, it has how you should use the meds, morning, afternoon, and so forth. So all of that is on the package, and we give that out. So we haven't really seen an increase in malaria cases, but we have a number of programs that we're working on in those communities.
Well, we have Mornin Barbados coming up at 6:30, so we hope you can stay by for what will be a very interesting day. Of course, we're still asking you if you're back to school ready last week to get in on that promotion, plus a visit by the president of Sir Optimist Club International of Great Britain and Ireland. She'll be paying us a visit today. And we're talking breast cancer screening and overall general health. That's all coming up today. Plus, the experts from CIBC First Caribbean are in. We're talking mortgages. That's all at 6:30. We hope you can join us then. But next, we have more news, some sports and weather. Stay with us.
For the past 19 years, QFM has been sharing with you, learning from you, and together building a community for all mature audiences. That's why we say Q is good for you. To our Q family, we say thank you for staying connected to Q 100.7 FM. QFM is a station of the Caribbean Broadcasting Corporation. CBC, celebrating 60, connecting Barbadian communities.
While you go about your business, we go about our business, and that is gathering the news. Stay up to date at CBC News Barbados on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Get news update on radio throughout the day. And join us for the CBC News Night at 7 every night. CBC.
Well, some good news this morning. Legislation is being drafted to protect the elderly from being cheated out of their money, among other things. Word of this from former Minister of People Empowerment and Elder Affairs, Cynthia Ford. Without going into greater detail, she indicated that for the full package to work, there's a need for more training to deal with the concerns of a growing aging population. Ms. Ford was standing in for her successor, Minister Kirk Humphrey, in addressing the church service of the Barbados Alzheimer's Association as it marks World Alzheimer's Month. CBC's Trevor Thorpe reports.
The St. Thomas Member of Parliament told the congregation in the Cathedral Church of St. Michael and All Angels, which included local and international medical stakeholders, as well as ministerial officials, that the training is aimed at taking care of the aged.
The Ministry of Education has given us a listening ear after all these years, and we're getting a National Development Scholarship, and I have asked for it to continue, whether it does or not, I would not know, in gerontology. We need more persons at that level to make the difference.
Ms. Ford expressed concern about the workload of the few gerontologists on the island, especially with the island's growing aging population. She says government has to put a plan in place to train more of them.
We cannot overburden the two or three or four that are on the island, because they too will get all kinds of trauma and get break down, and then we have to fall and bring in others, and there's nothing wrong with us bringing in others to help to support the system, but we need to have our own to be able to make the difference in the lives of others.
President of the Barbados Alzheimer's Association, Pamela Brereton, told the congregation age is not a factor with dementia and it is everybody's business. She said she supports the call for training in the sector and gave details of the impact on Barbadians.
More women get dementia than men. And you also might know that the majority of caregivers are women. The Office of the Barbados Alzheimer's Association will continue to educate, support, counsel, and advocate for all those suffering from dementia and their caregivers, especially to families whose knowledge is limited about the disease. Families need to understand that this is a disease and everyone needs to give of themselves and not leave the responsibility to one individual.
Trevor Thorpe, CBC News.
Well, thank you so much, Trevor. Now time to take a look at sports. Barbados Royals are the champions of the 2023 Massey Women's Caribbean Premier League. They won the final last evening against Guyana Amazon Warriors at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy in Trinidad. Batting first, Royals women were led by skipper Hayley Matthews to 169 for 7 off their 20 overs. Matthews was impressive with 82, inclusive of 10 fours and 2 sixes. Shabnim Ishmael took 4 for 30. We have some highlights from that innings.
Gotcha! Over the top. First boundary. Timed well enough. Oh, that's beautiful. That is sheer timing. That is a top shot. That is worth every penny to come into this ground and watch it. Lofty. Abner Ismail strikes back.
Oh, two leg side. Matthews dismisses it. I'll put it into the onside then, says Hayley Matthews. How about that?
Highlighted that strength offside.
Well, just to back it up, what a massy great shot from Matthews.
Crunched, placed, timed.
Matthews, that should be a 50, and is caressed backward a point. A half century.
The season, down the ground. Is that all the way? Yes, it is.
Now thrashing blade, the outside edge from Williams, is run away for four. Time for a little bit more gentle Osman. Here's an opportunity, is it? No. It's into a gap.
Through the offside, that is supreme. More runs here for the Royals. The Warriors. Will it go all the way? Yes. Bother. But straight away for the boundary, straight away for the boundary. And goes into the hands. Avoids the hat trick. That's high, that's high. Fielders converging and good catch. It's Matthews. And she nails this one straight to the captain. Swings the leg. Will get one. And will not have the chance to come back for a second. So 15 runs coming from the over. The Royals will think that they have done justice to batting first.
Congrats to the Royals women. Warriors women, in reply, fell short of 161 for 8 for Royals to win by 8 runs. Amanda Jade Wellington took 4 for 23, with 3 of her victims falling in the penultimate over, while player of the match, Matthews, got 2 for 38. While Shemaine Campbell scored 47 not out in a losing effort. Let's take a look now at the weather. The barometric pressure stands at 1012.2 millibars. It's 28.1 degrees Celsius outside already. Humidity stands at 80%, and the winds are coming out of the south-southeast at 8 kilometers per hour. Present temperature, fair. Sea conditions all across Barbados. Here's what you can expect. Moderate and open water with swells ranging from 1.5 to 2 meters and increasing. Here's a look at how your tides roll in today. Be careful as you head out to the beach for your early morning sea bath. General conditions for Barbados, a mix of sunshine and clouds with a few isolated light showers. And into the evening period, you can expect partly cloudy conditions with a few isolated light showers. That's the morning report. Our next newscast is Newsday at 12 noon on TV8, followed by The World at 1 on our radio network of stations. Morning Barbados is next.
Wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up. Barbados, get up.
Good morning.
Well, good morning to you indeed. Good to have you with us on this beautiful Monday morning. It's already September 11th. That's right. What a day. And you'd know that September 11th, 2001, 2,977 people were killed in what was the deadliest terror attacks in American history. That's right. The moment, of course, shocked the world as two planes hijacked by self-proclaimed jihadists plowed into both Twin Towers at the World Trade Center in New York, and another plane was flown into the Pentagon in Washington, D.C. A fourth plane, presumably headed for the White House or the U.S. Capitol, was heroically diverted by passengers and ended up crashing in a field in Pennsylvania. After reports of the first plane hitting the North Towers, millions watched the second plane hit the South Tower on live television. I remember that like it was yesterday. So to all of our Americans who are viewing, who are here in Barbados or viewing from certainly across the world online, we commiserate with you this morning. Many, many lives were lost during that horrific event. So again, welcome to Mornin Barbados on this Monday. Today was a hard start for me. I don't know how it worked for you, but it definitely felt like a Monday. You know, as we say, you know, those hard Mondays to kind of get out. But certainly good to have you with us. So if you're just tuning in, I'm Tisha Hines, and I'll be here with you until 8 o'clock this morning. We have a good show planned for you. So we have a visit from the president of the visiting Sir Optimist International of Great Britain and Ireland. I know you would have seen her in the press. She's been around and about and planting trees and doing some fantastic work with her counterparts here in Barbados. So she will be here to share more with us. So Deborah Joseph, our president from here in Barbados, Sir Optimist International Barbados, Catherine Cotteris, president of the Sir Optimist International of Great Britain and Ireland, will be here, as well as Jacqueline Pascal, who's president of the International Caribbean Network. Those ladies will be in to tell us all about the wonderful work they're doing. We're continuing our series today, too, with Dr. Dale Springer. Today, we're taking a look at breast health generally, but we're going to be talking about breast screening, most certainly as we look toward the big observance of Breast Cancer Awareness Month coming up in the month of October, where we have the What for Cure and so on. We wanted to get ahead of that and make sure that you're doing all of your screenings leading up to. Plus, we're talking general health with a naturopath, Dr. Dale Brathwaite. I'm sure he's no stranger to you, but it's been some while since he's been here with us on CBC. So he's going to be sharing a lot more with us, and we're going to be talking about taking good care of your general health and how important it is to make good choices. And we continue telling you more about Death Awareness Month. We started last week, and all this month we want to make sure that we continue to highlight some wonderful things that are happening. Now, there was a Calypso project that we want to share with you in observance of the month as well. Plus, we are talking mortgages with the experts. We've invited our friends from CIBC First Caribbean to come in and talk mortgages. We know lots of you are always interested in owning your own homes, and you may have questions. And of course, we have to bring the experts to you so that you know exactly what's going on and you can prepare for the future. We definitely want to talk about home ownership and what it can mean to your future and your children's future. So Jerome Gittins, who is a business development officer with CIBC First Caribbean, and Jerrianne Ince, relationship manager, Platinum Banking, CIBC First Caribbean International Bank, they graciously agreed to come on in and talk about it with us. Plus, we're continuing with the big promotion. Are you back to school ready? That's the big question. If you're between the ages of 8 and 15, you of course have to get in here, because we give you an opportunity to win and win big. You get a tech bundle, a chance at a tech bundle. So it's a headset, it's a tablet, and a printer. That's what you get a chance to win, only by calling in and showing us that you are indeed back to school ready. When I say go, or when I ask the question, that is the time that you come on in and get that done. So that and a whole lot more is what we have planned for you today. But we're going to start with the ladies of the Sir Optimist International Club, who are talking to us all about the visit by President Cotteridge, who is here in Barbados to tell us more about what's happening and to share in all that the Barbadian Club is doing as well. So good morning to you ladies and welcome.
Welcome, thank you so much.
All right, wonderful to have you with us. I wanna start with you, Madam President Deborah Joseph, Dr. Deborah Joseph, who is President of Sir Optimist International of Barbados. Set the tone for us of what it means to have these ladies be a part of your offering at this time.
Okay, good morning. Thanks for having us, and I'm so glad to be here. Yes, Sir Optimist International Barbados has been around for 60 years. We were founded in November 27, 1962, and we celebrated our 60th anniversary last year. So that is wonderful. What we do, we have numerous projects that we take part in, our members, in like the New Horizons project with girls who are, have challenges with the law. We have this Seroptimus Village and Activity Center at Eden Lodge, where we house 20 to 24 senior citizens, 60 years and over, for independent living. We do work with human trafficking. We do work with domestic violence. We are part of the National Organization of Women Network, and we support other women NGOs in that regard. So we fall under the Federation of Seroptimus International Great Britain and Ireland, of which President Cathy is visiting us. She is the president there. So it's so great for her to visit us to see what we are doing in the Caribbean, on her Caribbean tour. And President Jacqueline Pascal is the president of Seroptimus International Caribbean Network, a network of about 19 clubs in the Caribbean, Seroptimus International Barbados, Seroptimus International Jamestown, and other Caribbean clubs like Turks and Caicos, Jamaica, SI Esperance, Port of Spain, and Grenada, St. Vincent and the Grenadines, all are part of the Seroptimus International Caribbean Network, of which President Jacqueline Pascal leads. So that's just an overview of what we do. What we do, we empower, enable, and educate girls. And we all our programs and projects are surrounding that team in terms of our helping and supporting and advocate for that cohort.
Well, yes. we can absolutely close out the interview now. You covered just about everything. So let's go on over to President Catherine Cotteridge, President of the Seroptimus International of Great Britain and Ireland. Talk to us about this visit and some of your objectives for this particular one.
Thank you and good morning. I've had the most wonderful warm welcome since I arrived on Friday. It's my first visit to this part of the world. But the whole Seroptimus movement, it's an entirely volunteer movement, began in 1921. And the first challenge of the ladies in Oakland, California was to try to save the giant redwood trees, which were being rapidly lobbed by the logging company. So they lobbied the government and they saved the redwood trees. And there is now a Seroptimus reserve in Oakland, California. So that's how it all began. So in 2021, when we were celebrating our 100th anniversary, our centenary, it seemed appropriate that we had a centenary tree planting project. And that ran for a year from March 2021 to 2022. And I set what seemed a very ambitious target of 100,000 trees to be planted for 100 years. And I was absolutely overwhelmed the way the project just captured the imagination of all the countries in our federation, which include Asia and Malta. So we have branches in Pakistan, Sri Lanka, India, Nepal, Bangladesh, and in Malta and in the UK. And throughout that year, 125,290 trees were planted. And really significantly, were 33,000 mangrove saplings were planted on the Sundarbans in the Delta region. So the focus now very much for clubs, as Deb has mentioned, is on climate change and human trafficking. Climate change is, as you know, adversely affecting the Caribbean islands. We've had so many natural disasters in the last 5 years, but it does seem as if governments are finally waking up to the fact that it is a very real issue that we need to do something about urgently, particularly plastic pollution. So that's a big campaign here in the Caribbean. But all of the projects that the Caribbean islands are doing are so innovative and of a very high standard. And every year we have a conference and we award, we have the best practice awards for the best projects. And here in the Caribbean, they've consistently won an award every year since 2013 for the projects that they're doing. So I'm thoroughly looking forward to visiting the Seroptimus Village later on today. And it's just been wonderful to see the work that they're doing here. And I want to congratulate everybody. Thank you.
That's truly excellent. It's a wonderful work. I know that you ladies always do wonderful work. President Jacqueline Pastel, you are Sir Optimus International Caribbean Network. Talk to us now about how your work differs in kind of honing in on what's happening across the region.
Okay, good morning, and thanks for the opportunity to be here. Now, we are women inspiring action and transforming lives right across the Caribbean. As you have already heard, that we are from Jamaica to Trinidad. We are a group of women who do work around our advocacy work, as you already heard, on human trafficking. And we do work around social and gender justice, in particularly when it comes to domestic violence. We are right there. We coalesce around the UN commemorative events. So, for example, the 16 days of activism, the even International Men's Day. So we try to align ourselves with men so that we would have a decrease in what you know, which is very prevalent in domestic violence. So like looking at dismantling toxic masculinity around those issues we will work with. And just to give a little snapshot of what we do, for example, in Jamaica, just recently, the Jamaican Club would have done a health fair and would have captured 300 persons at that health fair. Women, men, everybody was there so that they could get screening for non-communicable diseases. I like to mention the sterling contribution that was made by the St. Vincent Club and the eruption of La Soufriere. All members when that happened, joined the national effort in supporting official shelters, families, and individuals, impacting about 3,000 people, 3,000 families. So you heard in Trinidad and Tobago, the fact that they are very much into climate action, they coalesce around bringing awareness to they say trash for treasure and issues like that. I like the fact that in Turks and Caicos, we have our clubs there looking at the welfare of women, elderly women, as Barbados mentioned, and I really like that village that is happening and it's been wrong for so long. So we are really pleased of our work that we do, and we are, as we said, we really be our access to social and gender justice, and we have been doing that for, as you know, 50 years, our anniversary, started with our sisters in 1973, and we are quite proud to be part of this movement.
Oh, wonderful. There's so much happening. I mean, we could talk about the efforts that you ladies are putting in for the entire show, and still, I assume we'll not be able to get through all of it. But I want to double back now, President Dr. Joseph, to that visit that President Cottridge talked about today to the Sir Optimus Village. Talk to us about what she'll be doing for the rest of her visit while she's here in Barbados, some of the more interesting stops she'll be making. I know we've seen her making her rounds in news. She's gone off to the botanical gardens. We saw all of that. So talk to us about some of the other places she'll be stopping by.
Okay, thank you so much. Yes, we have a visit to Her Excellency, Dame Sandra Mason. In a short while, we'll be heading there. And then after which, she will be heading to the Sir Optimus Village and Activity Center at Eden Lodge. She'll be touring the village to see the housing units and meet with the senior citizens that are residents there. And then we will have lunch with all the senior citizens that are residents there. And we have invited our sister club, SI Jamestown, to also be part of this activities. So that is what is in store for her today. So it's a very busy morning, as you can see, starting at 5:30 a.m. And Sir Optimus Village and Activity Center has been around for so long. Units were occupied since 1978. So that tells you about
the maintenance and so forth that we have to upkeep for those units. Now, during the COVID pandemic, we were not able to raise funds as we would like. So we are really appealing to corporate Barbados to help us and support us in this very important project, because we provide activities for seniors in the community and on the compound Tuesday, Wednesdays, and Thursdays from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. And folks in the community can bring their elder relatives there, and they have exercises that they do. They play bingo, they do dominoes and different activities, recreational activities to keep them healthy and enjoy their independent living.
Oh, wonderful.
So it's a flagship project that we have, and we really, really want to put the seniors, highlight the seniors and make them more visible in our country.
Yes. That's very, very important. I want to thank you ladies for coming through. The time has flown by, but I'm sure you're going to make sure that you keep us updated on all that you're doing. Not only here in Barbados, but the region and the world as well. It's wonderful to see that we're having a visit as well, so that we can share in all that we're doing here in Barbados. And again, congratulations. President Cottridge noted that you've won awards for your very ambitious projects since 2013. It means that we're doing fantastic regional work in that area. So thank you, ladies, and all the best. We certainly look forward to seeing all of the other high points of the trip.
Thank you so much for having us. Enjoy the rest of your day. Thanks, ladies. Bye-bye.
It's my lucky day. Where else do you get to have three presidents all together on screen?
And women.
And women. Three women presidents. All right. Absolutely good stuff having them with us. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we are talking breast cancer screening. Stay with us.
Morning, good morning to you.
While you go about your business, we go about our business, and that is gathering the news. Stay up to date at CBC News Barbados on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Get news update on radio throughout the day, and join us for the CBC News Night at 7 every night. CBC News team is on the job and bringing you the news.
There is a saying, you can find a Bajan anywhere. Are you a Bajan living abroad? Or do you know of one who has migrated to another country? Well, we at Mornin Barbados would love to have you or them on our Bajan Afar segment. Share your amazing stories, experiences, and how you have adapted to a new culture. Send us an email to morningbarbados@cbc.vb, and together we will travel the world.
All right, so we've been sharing with you through a series with Dr. Dale Springer, Consultant General and Breast Surgeon at the QEH, and he's back with us this morning as we look toward the official observance in October. We want to make sure that your heads are in the right place when we talk about breast cancer and screening. Good morning to you, Dr. Springer. Welcome. Good to have you with us.
Hi, good morning. Thank you. Always a pleasure to be here.
Absolutely. So I want to get into screening and start there very early. Some women tend to run away from breast cancer screening. I've heard women talk about it being painful to be able to get the screenings done. But I believe this was in the past. Things have changed quite a bit. I'm not sure. So let's talk about the screening process, first of all.
Yeah, so screening basically refers to doing checks on your breasts before you develop any symptoms. So you're perfectly well, no complaints. You're just getting your breast checked to make sure there's no underlying problem. And screening is important because it allows us to diagnose conditions early, and that would hopefully mean, in majority of times, less intensive treatments and better survival. Yeah? In terms of the process, most people think about screening as being a mammogram usually when you get to the age of 40, and that's part of the process, but it's actually a process that starts way before the age of 40. And it's usually a process of shared decision-making, a consultation between you and your health. The first thing is you have to make sure that the patient has no symptoms related to the breasts. No breast lumps, no discharge from nipples, no lumps under the arm. The same symptoms that we have discussed in the previous program. Yes, and then if you don't have any symptoms, then you also go ahead and assess the patient's risk for breast cancer. We try to categorize patients basically as average risk or above average risk or high risk. So the persons who are average risk, the majority of them would have, we recommend to start mammograms at the age of 40 and do them yearly. So I think that's where your question about the discomfort comes in. Yeah, it's gotten better. Some women still do have discomfort because of the compression of the breast that we have to give so that we can get a clearer picture. But I always tell patients it will last for a little bit, the week at the most, and the amount of information that we can get from the investigations is so valuable, it is worth the discomfort. And many women don't have a discomfort. It's just a small minority that do.
Can we look a little bit about at age distribution in terms of stats of breast cancer around the world? Are there any particular ages of women that are more susceptible that should be far more interested or screening a lot more than others?
But as breast cancer increases with age, yeah? So the 50s, the 60s, you see a peak, and in some places the 70s. But in our population, from the noted data we see, there's actually a left shift. So we actually see incidence of rising quite early. Yeah. So that being said, it's not really ideal to wait until you're in the 50s or 60s to start screening. Yeah. So we recommend most persons start at 40. If you are high risk and you have a genetic predisposition, or if you have multiple family members who have you may even start your screening earlier, even in the mid-20s sometimes.
So let's talk about the recommended guidelines then first for breast screening, and at what age should women begin regular screenings?
Right. So persons who are average risk, that means, and the average risk is 1 in 8 or 12.5%, they should normally start around 40. Most guidelines would say start at 40. Some, the European guidelines would say have a discussion at 40, but aim to start at 45. But again, because of what the picture we are seeing here, we tend as a medical community here to encourage women to start at 40 in terms of doing their screening. And then persons who are definitely high risk, either based on a genetic predisposition or when we calculate their risk using one of the standardized risk calculators, they will end up starting around 25, mid-20s. And their screen is a little different. Not only would we use the mammogram, but in those young patients at high risk, we would also consider using breast MRI. And these tests are basically alternated every 6 months. Yes, because we have to have a more intensive surveillance for those young patients who are proven to be at high risk. And for high risk in young persons, there's a risk of over 20%, a lifetime risk of over 20% of developing breast cancer.
All right, so how accurate are these breast cancer screening methods? What are the potentials for false positives and false negatives in terms of rates?
Right, so the breast cancer screening methods are reasonably accurate. If you look at the mammogram, we see it's about 10 to 15% of patients will have a lesion that is not identified on the mammogram. So over 85% will have something that is there and that is identified. So no test is 100% perfect. Yes, and what the test does do, it clues you in that, hey, there could be something that is going on here. So if you do have a positive screening test, your screening mammogram, for example, you may be called back to do additional views where they want to have a look a little closer at the area. Or you may even go on to do a biopsy where they have to take a sample of tissue from the area where the abnormality is seen on the mammogram.
Dr. Springer, can you explain the process of a mammogram or other breast screening techniques in terms of, you know, including the potential for discomfort, which is what I talked about as one of the many things that a lot of women say that they run away from. Can you explain it a little in greater detail for us?
Right. So the process basically involves, normally the doctor, the patient, make sure that they don't have any symptoms. The physical examination would be done, again, for any lumps in the breasts, any retraction of the nipple, any concerning findings, and then they would proceed to the mammogram. Yes, in terms of that, the ICU is a special type of x-ray. Yeah, but to get the images, you have to apply compression to the breast. Normally, it's done in two views, two perpendicular views. So top to bottom and then side to side. So that is where the discomfort comes in. But the compression allows you to spread out the breast tissue over a greater area when you compress it, so that the x-rays can then penetrate and give you a good picture. So yes, some patients who have sensitive breasts will have this discomfort, and it's a recognized, I don't want to say complication, but it's something that occurs when you have mammograms, but it doesn't last. It doesn't last for a long period of time, not even if you get beneficial information. As you know, you have, most people have two breasts, so you'll repeat the process on the other side when you finish one. And it's usually a day procedure, so in after you're finished, you can go home and return to your normal activities.
All right, and finally, are there any lifestyle modifications, for example, that can reduce the risk of developing breast cancer?
Yes, definitely. Sometimes we will talk about this in coming programs. We just talk about a few of them in terms of diet. You want to apply a diet that is not high in fatty foods. You want to try to minimize your alcohol consumption. You also want to exercise as much as possible, but a minimum of 30 minutes for 5 days, 5 days out of the week, every week. There are also some other lifestyle factors that has to do that have to do with your avoiding of certain medications that may have in hormones, for example, estrogen. That's one of the main hormones, but that is something I think we will discuss perhaps in another show. Because, and then sometimes it's not possible, or if possible, you need to avoid those medications. Then there are some risk factors that unfortunately we cannot avoid, such as our genetics. Yes. And then that's where it comes into play to be screened early, so we can detect this condition early, and then even offer prophylactic treatment at some points in time.
Now, we had Dr. Shirley Jagro, who was here with the walk manager for the upcoming Walk for a Cure late last week, sharing with us about the upcoming promotions that they're doing for the walk and so on. And one of the things that she said that stays with me is that they've been seeing people who are presenting way earlier. They're not getting the presentation of, you know, the late stages of breast cancer. So let's talk about the survival rate, so people know how important it is to do these screenings and how it can change the outcome of a potential negative diagnosis.
Right, so with screening, when it's really done well, we see a lot of what we call ductal carcinoma in situ. Some people refer to it as baby cancer, but what that means is that it has the potential to progress to cancer. It is potentially a lesion that can go on to become, but it's not cancerous yet. So oftentimes when we do screenings on the mammogram, we find this here. And it doesn't have the potential to spread, so it's not invasive cancer. And when we treat that, the cure rate is almost 100%, approaching 99% survival at 5 years. And you find an early lesion that is microscopic, something that you can't feel, but it can be seen on the mammogram just by the abnormality. And it's a small lesion, what we'll end up probably calling a stage one lesion once there are no lymph nodes involved or any spread. They also have a good 5 year survival in the region of 90-95%. Yeah, and a lot of times these patients may not even need to have some of the therapies, the chemotherapy, especially if these lesions are found early. So this goes to speak to the importance of screening, as we alluded to at the start of the segment. The earlier we find these lesions, the less intensive treatment that will be required, and often the better the survival will be, and the better prognosis will be.
Thank you so much, Dr. Dale Springer, Consultant General and Breast Surgeon at the QEH. Always insightful. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you very much for having me. Have a good day.
All right, we're going to take a break for news. Stay with us.
Morning, morning, morning.
Good morning. Good morning to you.
Enjoy movies, soaps, drama, comedy, inspiration, education, music, and more. You get it all when you get MCTV, because MCTV gives you more.
The facts say Morning Barbados reaches an audience of over 50,000 and Newsnight reaches over 56,000. It's simple. When you advertise, you're getting your message to over 50,000 of your potential customers. Make the call to CBC Sales Department today and watch your business grow. Contact us at 467-5559 or email marketing@cbc.bb.
One's a one. It's more than a station.
We don't just play music. We keep your company, cheer you up, keep you informed and entertained. We are a vibe. What do you mean?
Morning, morning, morning.
Good morning. Good morning to you.
It's Monday, September 11th. Let's take a look at the news. Legislation is being drafted to protect the elderly from being cheated out of their money, among other things. Word of this from former Minister of People Empowerment and Elder Affairs, Cynthia Ford. Without going into greater detail, she indicated that for the full package to work, there is a need for more training to deal with the concerns of a growing, aging population. Ms. Ford was standing in for her successor, Minister Kirk Humphrey, in addressing the church service of the Barbados Alzheimer's Association as it marks World Alzheimer's Month. CBC's Trevor Thorpe reports.
The St. Thomas Member of Parliament told the congregation in the Cathedral Church of St. Michael and All Angels, which included local and international medical stakeholders, as well as ministerial officials, that the training is aimed at taking care of the aged.
The Ministry of Education has given us a listening ear after all these years, and we're getting a National Development Scholarship. And I have asked for it to continue, whether it does or not, I would not know, in gerontology. We need more persons at that level to make the difference.
Ms. Ford expressed concern about the workload of the few gerontologists on the island, especially with the island's growing aging population. She says government has to put a plan in place to train more of them.
We cannot overburden the two or three or four that are on the island, because they too will get all kinds of trauma and get break down. And then we have to fall and bring in others. And there's nothing wrong with us bringing others to help to support the system. But we need to have our own to be able to make the difference in the lives of others.
President of the Barbados Alzheimer's Association, Pamela Brereton, told the congregation age is not a factor with dementia and it is everybody's business. She said she supports the call for training in the sector and gave details of the impact on Barbadians.
More women get dementia than men. And you also might know that the majority of caregivers are women. The Office of the Barbados Alzheimer's Association will continue to educate, support, counsel, and advocate for all those suffering from dementia and their caregivers, especially to families whose knowledge is limited about the disease. Families need to understand that this is a disease and everyone needs to give up themselves and not leave the responsibility to one individual.
Trevor Thorpe, CBC News.
Thank you, Trevor. Barbados Royals are the champions of the 2023 Massey Women's Caribbean Premier League. They won the final last evening against Guyana Amazon Warriors at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy in Trinidad. Batting first, Royals women were led by skipper Haley Matthews to 169 for 7 off their 20 overs. Matthews was impressive with 82, inclusive of 10 fours and 2 sixes. Shabneem Ishmael took 4 for 30. We have highlights from that innings.
Over the top. First boundary. Oh, that's beautiful. That is sheer timing. That is a top shot. That is worth every penny to come into this ground and watch it. Lofted. Shabnam Ismail strikes back.
Oh, two leg side. Matthews dismisses it. I'll put it into the onside then, says Haley Matthews. How about that?
Highlighted that strength offside.
Well, just to back it up, what a massy great shot from Matthews.
Crunched, placed, timed.
Matthews, that should be a 50, and is caressed backward a point. A half century.
The season, down the ground. Is that all the way? Yes, it is.
Now, thrashing blade, the outside edge from Williams is run away for four. Time for a little bit more gentle Osman. Here's an opportunity, is it? No, it's into a gap.
Through the offside, that is supreme.
More runs here for the Royals. The Warriors. Will it go all the way? Yes. Bother. But straight away for the boundary. Straight away for the boundary. And goes into the hands. Avoids the hat trick. That's high, that's high. Fielders converging and good catch. It's Matthews. And she nails this one. Straight to the captain. Swings the leg. Will get one. And will not have the chance to come back for a second. So 15 runs coming from the over. The Royals will think that they have done justice to batting first.
Warriors women in reply fell short on 161 for 8 for Royals to win by 8 runs. Amanda Jade Wellington took 4 for 23 with 3 of her victims falling in the penultimate over, while player of the match Matthews got 2 for 38. Shemaine Campbell scored 47 not out in a losing effort. And that's our update of news. Remember, we have another newscast coming your way at 12 noon here on TV8, which will be followed by The World at 1 on our radio network of stations. Morning Barbados continues after this.
Morning, morning, morning.
Good morning. Good morning to you. Morning, morning.
Good morning. Good morning to you.
All right, just about 10 minutes after 7 o'clock. It's September 11th. That means there's 1 week left to get ready for back to school. So the question is, are you back to school ready? Make sure you get close to the telephone lines, because who knows when I'll tell you that you can call in for a chance to win a tech bundle, compliments of the Mornin Barbados team. Of course, we're giving you a headset, you're getting a tablet and a printer. All lots to look forward to. Get the little ones ready. You have to be between the ages of 8 and 15 for a chance to win. All right, so today we are starting a new series of sorts, welcoming back a familiar face for most of us. If you're just meeting him, his name is Dr. Dale Brathwaite, and he's a naturopath. He's been with the CBC in various iterations through the years. And today we're taking a look generally at what we can do to kind of get on a healthier track, which is very, very important. Good morning, Dr. Brathwaite. Always great to see you. Welcome.
Good morning.
All right. For those people who don't know, let's talk a little bit about your background, because you have a background in athletics, general health and well-being. You're an author as well. So there's a lot of dimension to you.
Yes, ma'am. Before I go too far, I want to say thanks to CBC. As I was saying to several persons, if CBC wants me, I've got most things and get here, because almost everything I've done, CBC has been there.
Yeah.
And I am writing my training. That is called Beyond the ATM Man and the Lady with a Friend.
Okay.
So that's what I'm looking at. I want to say good morning to my daughter, Amanda. Yes, back to Hartman College.
Congratulations.
Oh, thank you. In the my concern in all that we're going through is that I want to look at fat and fat burning and fitness.
All right. Okay, just hold on a minute. We have to correct a bit of a technical difficulty. So until we get there, just want to remind you to keep on viewing as we tell you all about the back to school promotion. Get close to your telephone lines. Like I told you, you don't know exactly when we are going to jump in there and give you an opportunity to call in to win. What we do is we ask you three simple questions for the little ones. So you come in. Again, you have to be between the ages of 8 and 15, and you give us a call on 228-5562 or 228-5563, and we give you an opportunity to win that tech bundle. So it's a headset, it's a tablet, and it's also a printer. I know that you're preparing for back to school next week, so the parents will be getting all the little bibs and bobs and last minutes stuff to be able to get the children ready for back to school on Monday. All right, let's see if we are ready with you, Dr. Brathwaite, once again. We had a bit of a technical challenge. You know how it goes sometimes for live TV, so we must apologize for the break for our viewers, most certainly. But you were just about to tell us, you know, all about the background.
Yes, run a little bit, paint a little bit. Write a little bit, and counsel a little bit, marriage officer, doctor of naturopathy, and a little bit more things.
Yeah.
But I thank God, and being in my 50s now, 54 to be exact, I think in the next 50 years, I need to die empty. So you got to give away some information. It don't make no sense. You know all of this, as you know, you would bury the dead and you see a eulogy. This body had this. So what did they do? Yeah. What did they leave behind for the next generation to go forward?
Yeah.
And these things continue to bother me, because Caribbean writers we need, and we need our Caribbean people to speak into Caribbean life and existence, that we can become a stronger people going forward. So one of my concerns as I look at us, I am seeing Australia having a problem with obesity. I think they're pointing towards 2/3 the population getting pleasantly plump, and we are not sure what to do. So a lot of lifestyle changes are upon us. We're having more sedentary persons, and in track and field, you're moving from sedentary to active back to sedentary. How does this work? Then people, like when people come with me, you know, they say, you're giving me no diet, no this, no that. I say, hold a minute, boss, I know nothing about you. So to just give you something, it becomes a problem. The other thing in conjunction with that, people want to lose weight. And I say to them, I am not giving you a lose weight plan. I want you to start toning. Because when we look at the issue of fat and fat burning, fat has had a bad rap with most persons. And then you do, these people got these boot camps that we watch on the internet or YouTube, and that burns for a while, but then they say, but I tried this and I ain't getting this work. There is a way to make it work. And the word diet comes along as two mango leaves, a moringa leaf, and a glass of water, and I'm on a diet. That will not work. One of the things, self-management and a long-term view has to be one of the primary answers. When we look at fat, fat is our friend. If the human doesn't have fat, he can't live. If there is no fat, a child will not be produced. Guys wouldn't have sperm count. Fat and cholesterol are friends. For a child to develop in the womb, there must be fat. For the first 2 years of a child's life to prepare us for that shoot off into adulthood, there must be fat. And those first 2 years, I'm talking about obesity, don't rush our minds there yet. Fat is important. And it is an insulator, it helps us. And there are primarily two types of fat. Fat under the skin, and then fat around the organs. There are two words, the V and the S, visceral and subcutaneous fat. And when you look at it, somebody skinny like me, you know, you say, but he looks at healthy, he dropped him, you see a heart attack. Why is that happening? Because the fat that is around my organs was too much for my muscles and organs to do their flexing. So you find, I'm saying to people, don't just rush and say, go on a diet. Check your primary care facilitator first, your doctor. Because sometimes, once an individual has been pleasantly plump for a while, you can rest assured that there will be organ difficulty. You can rest assured that your arteries are doing some things that they ought not to be doing. So there's a lack of clarity and fluidity going on. So your primary care physician, he or she, that trained healthcare provider will be able to do some tests, from blood tests to different types of pressure tests, and say, all right, look, this is what is happening. This information then should be given to your fitness professional, and he or she, in consultation with the doctor, can help you to get on what we call a healthier program.
All right, so let's start at the beginning. That's a good framework to lay out in terms of how you really should approach just getting healthy and taking care of yourself.
Yes.
So where do you start? People who, as you mentioned before, you know, are often in that mode where you feel like, I need to drop some pounds. I can be healthier. I can eat better. You know, where do you start? What's the chicken and the egg?
All right. One of the starting points is to recognize that maybe you do have a problem, you have a desire, you have a dream, and I want to just shape it different. You don't want to lose weight. Losing weight will not help you. You need to tone. Good musculature depends on fat. Fat feeds muscles. In our bodies, fats, carbohydrates, and proteins, there is what we call your energy systems and what we do to have energy. Intertwined in our brains, our bodies, some people get difficulty, as the surgeon just said, sometimes genetic issues popping up. All of us have the genetic quotas and what's not. And you find that some people are predisposed to some psychomedical challenges. Inside of that, we can still learn how to reduce this fat quota. When we look at the human, one of the things that you find, fat has a molecular formula, atoms and stuff. So you have carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. When you exercise, you're burning all of that, you know. Carbon, under room temperature and under, is solid. Oxygen causes an individual to get healthier and stops you from being predisposed to carcinoma, cancer. When we put all of these things together, when we get water, the formula H2O, two atoms to one, the oxygen, all of these words keep coming back up. Why? Because there's a family. When an individual starts to fat burn, the fat takes a different structure and it comes out as a gas through your mouth or your nose. If an individual refuses to fat burn. That is, if he or she remains in that place of the sedentary lifestyle, you ain't gonna burn nothing. So dieting will be a challenge. People talk about cholesterol. That's your friend. If you don't have cholesterol, you can't function. Because the similar to vitamin K, cholesterol helps with, or when somebody gets cut, to heal. Cholesterol
to strike the balance. Which is where we need to kind of find that medium where you strike the balance, where you're not way over the top with the cholesterol. We hear people talking about high cholesterol, and then of course all of the other fat that you talked about around the organs and so on. So how do you strike the balance?
All right. One of the things is this. I say to people, let's begin looking at some stuff. As the cameras are on me, you can zoom into my side. Watch this here. If you grab your side, people from over in the way, if you hold your side, you can interpret in English to me. And you do so and you grab. And it is more than an inch, which is like your index finger. Your borderline it on.
Well, don't gotta tell you, I get more than an inch.
Right. don't dig nothing. So then you do so and grab your front now. And you can ball it up so in your hand.
I can ball it your front.
Right? You do so and you know that your thing is. So there are different measurements that are used, but the male needs to keep about what? Between five and 10% body fat. And the female, I think, is about 10 to 12. If you go under, you're starting to head for problems. That's one. The second thing, when we started to look at rhythm and fluidity, one has to start to get active. And this isn't a get up one morning and see you going for a big long run. That is pure foolishness. So you start looking at, you get it on the morning and you have an intention to get fit. Start in your own home. Rather than go outside and so forth, start walking around for 15 minutes.
In the house?
In the
house. Yeah.
You get me? So that as you do that, you're preparing, you have a plan, because adjustment takes about 21 days. I think that's 3 weeks. 3 by 7 is 21. Good. So to make adaptation, you have to look at giving your body the chance not to enter into shock. Shock is for the highly athletic. If you want to get from 11 seconds to 10 seconds, we have to do some shocks, relax, and so forth, and keep going. But for the person who wants to tone, you have to heat the body in order to burn the deposits which you have. A lot of us want more money. When you get the money, the buzzword is Dubai. I think CBC brought it. There's a place that people are going to. I think you interviewed the person too. They're taking cruises.
Panama.
You got it, man. I can't remember that. But people want to do something. So what are they doing with the money that they've saved? They're using it. Likewise, fat is a deposit that we have a choice. We can leave it there or we can use it. If we're using it, then it goes to our benefit. Now, there is carbon and then there's that hydrogen. When we got that, there's an energizer inside there. So an individual is not burning what the deposit that was made. When you start to burn, you start to get what is called the aha moment. Well, I'm feeling a little better. But sometimes, because individuals may have been sedentary for so long, they will take a little longer to feel it. But consistency in action and activity, you will get there. And you have to give yourself, in naturopathy, if an individual had something for 5 years, it takes me about, according to the studies, 2.5 years to deal with. Now I use a lot of machines and stuff and try to cut down that time. So you find you've got to give yourself some time. In addition to giving yourself some time, you got to think about gear. There are certified sport shops and people with specialized gear to help. And people have to look at quality footwear, because of the technical nature of not wanting to advertise product. You have to look at high-end stuff.
Okay.
As I said, if you are buying footwear and over time you'll develop all of these points. Your foot, in going into your shoe, your index finger has to go to the back of the shoe whilst your foot is at the front, whereby the heel. And if your foot, if your index finger cannot get between the heel and the back of the shoe is too tight.
Okay.
So go ahead. You look as though you got asked.
Yeah, I mean
you've said so much, but we can only get to so much in each program. So we want to do a few key takeaways, at least two. The key takeaways from today's presentation are, don't try to get everything in at once.
Right.
You want to start slowly. Even if it means moving around your house for 15 minutes every morning when you wake up, just moving around outside or maybe even inside the house and getting that body going, getting the body accustomed to the thought of movement a whole lot more than the sedentary or just a laid back type lifestyle. So that is the one major takeaway. And the next thing is to get yourself some nice footwear. It might cost a little more, but it's important to be able to get footwear to help you on that journey. And you want to make sure that the index finger
goes to the back of the shoe properly.
All right,
so we're going to take a pause there. So those are two things that we're challenging you to do by next week. So get those shoes and start moving around. Just 15 minutes in the morning for the next 3 weeks is what we're going to be moving working on. So while we take this break, I'm going to start walking around the studio. Yeah, that's my thing. All right, thank you so much, Dr. Dale Brathwaite. Great start, I think, generally a good talk. And it's always great when you don't have someone kind of looking out saying, this is what you need to do, and that's very important. So we certainly hope that we've challenged you to at least make the start. We'll be right back. Stay with us.
Morning, morning, morning.
Good morning. To you.
We enjoy a game of dominoes and singing karaoke.
I just love crew.
When you love me just a little bit longer.
You get to relax and have a drink and listen to some nice music.
It's something different. It's spectacular. It's fabulous. You know, it's a different feeling altogether.
Follow me to Q in the Community this Thursday.
You know why?
It's summer vacation, and CBC TV 8 says, laugh a little. Your mid-mornings have now included some family-friendly, side-splitting series like The Partridge Family, Benson, and Designing Women. TV not to be missed this vacation. Weekdays from 10 a.m. on CBC TV 8.
Morning, morning, morning.
Good morning. Good morning to you.
It's already 7:30. I can't believe how quickly the time goes by, but it's 7:30 already. Remember, we're still running that Are You Back to School Ready promotion. So when I tell you, you have to call us up on 228-5562 and 228-5563 for a chance to win that tech bundle that we're offering here at Mornin Barbados. Now, earlier we told you that you might be in the market for a mortgage, or you might be looking for a little help. Maybe you want to switch it up. Maybe it's that time you're feeling like, I need to own my piece of the rock. What do I do? Where do I go? Hey, so we invited the experts from CIBC First Caribbean to join us here on Mornin Barbados to share more about it with you, so you have an idea of how easy it can be for you to be able to get your own home as we take a particular interest in home ownership. So let's welcome Business Development Officer with CIBC First Caribbean International Bank, Jerome Gittins, to Mornin Barbados. Good morning. Good to have you with us.
Good morning, Tisha. It's great to be on with you today.
All right. So I know you hear this a lot, and of course we've heard it as Barbadians, everybody wants to own a piece of the rock. That is most certainly something that a lot of Barbadians hold to their close to their hearts, and they look forward to doing. It's one of those milestones that we don't want to jump past. So how possible is it in 2023 for someone to say, hey, I'd like to own my own home, start by maybe building or buying something? Where do they need to start?
Yeah, so we are here to share that good news with Barbados that home ownership is achievable. It, of course, will take some planning. There are some costs that, you know, that you will incur. And therefore, we believe at this time, because as you said, Barbadians are very interested in home ownership. And as we recover from the pandemic, people, we are seeing more and more interest in the mortgage space. And therefore, CIBC First Caribbean thought it appropriate that we should offer some relief to those prospective homeowners at this time in order to aid them and assist them in ways that they could, you know, have that ownership of the home that they're looking for.
Oh, that's excellent. Let's welcome Jerrianne Ince, who is Relationship Manager, Platinum Banking with CIBC First Caribbean International Bank, to the conversation. Good to have you with us as well. I'm convinced we're going to have a rounded conversation today. So there may be a few categories of people who are looking for a home. Might be someone who wants to buy a home, someone who wants to build a home. Maybe someone has a home already and wants to switch and get a different mortgage, so maybe they can access a little equity and do some improvement on the home that they have. So talk to us, Jerrianne, about the services that you offer at CIBC First Caribbean that can help people achieve those goals.
Well, again, thank you for having us, and a special good morning to your viewers. Essentially, what we are here this morning to deliver is a message, an invitation really, to your viewers to come get comfy with CIBC First Caribbean. Come have a comfortable conversation with us, a comfortable experience, and comfort in your pocket. If you're looking to build, buy, or if you're not so comfortable with your existing financial institution, come on over and get comfortable with us. The campaign is running between now and the 31st of October 2023, so we encourage you to come speak with us as soon as possible. The savings range from discounted facility fees, or what we call application fees, up to 2,000 Barbados dollars. We also offer home insurance, so you get savings there up to 1,000 Barbados dollars. And valuation costs is a document you must have. So we are saying we are going to assist you with that cost up to 500 Barbados dollars.
All right, so lots happening for us to be able to get that happening. In terms of, you know, usually when people want a mortgage, they have to start by coming in and maybe getting an assessment done, Jerome, so they know exactly, you know, what they can get, how much they can qualify for. So let's talk about that particular process of getting in and finding out what would be available to you.
Yeah, so of course, you said it perfectly. People sometimes just want to know, can I really afford this mortgage? Is this something that I can do at this point in time? And that's starting with your banker, starting with CIBC First Caribbean is the way to go. So we want to hear persons calling. You can go online, you can submit an application online, but before you actually do that, you can actually talk to us. And what we really are assessing, Tisha, we are really seeking to find out, can this person be able to repay this mortgage based on their income, based on their expenses? So the expenses, you may have a loan, you may have a credit card, you may have a higher purchase debt, you may have a line of credit, some credit facility that you have, and of course, there are living expenses that would be also a part of our assessment. So we ideally would talk to our customers, go through that bit of information with them to ascertain from them how possible it is for based on your income and based on your expenses, your situation, based on your financial situation, how possible it is for you to afford this mortgage.
All right.
And those are the basic steps that we will follow.
All right. So the important thing is to reach out, first of all, because you yes. can't make assumptions. You have to make sure that you reach out so that you can find out the information. Might be helpful to write a few questions down so that once you get into the good folks at CIBC First Caribbean, you have those questions that might be the burning questions. I know, Jerry-Ann, one of the questions that people want to know first up and straight off is, what do I qualify for? So
magic number.
Yeah, so I need to know how to manage my expectations. You know, champagne taste, mobby pocket. Yeah, so you know, that's absolutely a great place to start. And I see that with this particular promotion that you are embarking on, you know, it starts from $140,000, and that means we're including everyone. Because sometimes when we think of mortgages, we think, okay, you know, you're well over $300,000 or this, that. No, you know, I'm happy to see that people can come on in and get mortgages from as low as $140,000. Talk to that.
Yeah, so we are very inclusive. We are starting from those who are quite young, just started to work. Of course, we're really encouraging you young take advantage of your age, because of course, the younger you are, the longer the term the bank can extend to you. Yes, very inclusive. If any person looking to purchase, buy, construct, or move your mortgage should come in and have a conversation with us, lay everything on the table. We can give you what we call your magic number, in what is essentially the maximum you can qualify for, or we can also work with you in relation to what you are comfortable paying month on month and tell you what that translates to.
Oh, that's excellent. And there are some people who might have a little savings that they can put in, but I understand you're offering up to 95% of financing. Tell us what that means, Jerome.
Yes. So if, for instance, I mean, if you have a property, you're interested in a property, let's say it costs you $400,000. Of course, there is some contribution on the part of the prospective homeowner. And we are saying to Barbadians, 5% of your personal equity cash is necessary in order that we can actually process that mortgage application for you. Let me also say, Tisha, though, there are cases where persons may own their own land already and they want to build. This, in a scenario like this, persons may even qualify for 100% financing. That is an option as well. That's a possibility. So for the outright purchase of land, a property, our offer is 95% financing, but in cases where you own your own land, you may have a loan already, or you may not even owe anyone for that piece of land. It is very possible, I'm saying to Barbados, it is possible that you can have 100% financed.
You definitely gave it the correct name. Get comfy, because it doesn't seem like you have to put that much effort into, you know, getting what you need at all. What I also love as a homeowner myself is, especially when you get started with that mortgage, sometimes it can be a little challenging to get in there with the expenses that go along with owning your own home, insurance, and you know, paying your insurance and things like that. And you've thought of all of that at CIBC First Caribbean, so you're offering an opportunity for you know, people to sign on to have installments towards their insurance as well, Jerome.
Yes, Tisha, that is a great point. And we, as you said, we at CIBC First Caribbean, we thought about that, and we are offering a cash back, which is also going to aid in persons you know, having the ease of obtaining their insurance. We also have what we call our easy cover loan payment option, which allows for persons to pay their home insurance over an 11-month period. Now, this facility that we offer, the easy cover, is actually interest-free, teacher, believe it or not. There's no interest. It's really to facilitate the payment of that insurance. And we know that could be a burden in some cases to some people. It could be difficult, you know, being able to cover those costs. What we're also going to do along with that easy cover loan, teacher, we are also going to offer up to 1,000 Barbados dollars. I don't know if you heard what I said. 1,000 Barbados off that home insurance. If that home insurance is taken with CIBC First Caribbean through the CG United package that we have. So we have thought about it. We have delivered something that we believe that Barbadians can really benefit for in terms of having owning your own home.
It's tried and proven.
Comfy. Yes.
All right, good stuff. It's tried and proven. Now, if people are anything like me, they love to get online and find out more information. So can we get online to find out more information before we even make that advance to come on into the bank?
Yes. Of course, our website, cibcfcib.com. Just go there, look for those offers that we have. You want to see the Get Comfy flashing on the screen. It's one of our major campaigns for the year. As Jerianne said, it started actually in August and it runs all the way to October 31st. One of the things that we want to ensure is that people not only get the mortgage or they're qualified for the mortgage, but the process happens quickly. So we engage with our attorneys, we engage with those persons that are involved to ensure that this process happens quickly. So we implore Barbadians to come talk to CIBC First Caribbean. We believe that this offer is going to jumpstart your property ownership. It's going to be comfortable for you. The process is going to be seamless. We are here to serve you, Barbadians, and we want to see you own your own home.
For sure. And I love the idea of first-time homeowners, you know, getting really, really comfy with the idea of owning their own homes. But I know for people who might have a mortgage already and they want to move that mortgage to maybe First Caribbean Bank, you know, is the process a little different for them? What do they need to do in order to be able to make that move, to make a move?
Yes. So we all know that persons are not comfy with their mortgages, right? They have their own home. The payments are maybe, you know, not what they want. They want to do some renovations. They want to send their children to school. They want to do something additional using that equity that you mentioned earlier. And we are able and we are right and ready to be able to offer that person an easy move. And of course, there is a cost attached. We all know this. So you're not just moving your mortgage, there are also some additional costs. And we thought about that. Therefore, we are offering up to $20,000 US, $10,000 that will assist that person in their moving cost. We know that this will cost something. And we've thought about that at CIBC First Caribbean.
Okay, that's excellent. I know you have some fantastic partners on board. When we think about, there are a lot of people who they think about buying stuff, but when you're a homeowner, places like Ace, H&B Hardware, Standard, and Harris Paints, when you hear those names, you get excited, right? And
yes,
you have them on board as your partners as well.
Absolutely. So in addition to that first-time homeowner, that person that wants to switch, we are also going to offer you a gift card that you can use that gift card at some select stores that we have identified, Ace, H&B, Hardware, Standard, Harris Paints. These are stores, of course, when you're building, you're touching up your home, you're doing some renovations. We know that these are the stores that you, some of the stores that you would want to made purchases from. And we have therefore decided that we will, up to 3 months after that mortgage has been placed on our books, that we will offer these homeowners the opportunity to shop there with discounts.
T-shirt. All right. So that's excellent. I've been taking note all along. So it's the Get Comfy promotion and it runs down to the end of October. So you don't have a very long time. Make sure that you get in. You still have, you know, just over a month, but you want to make sure you get in there and at least start with a question, because this can be quite a lengthy process as well. You know, you can go on it. You're going to get a minimum loan amount of as little as $140,000, minimum loan period of 10 years. And then, of course, you get lots of benefits. Of course, it's up to 95% financing, but it's contingent on what's happening with you. Because Jerome told us that if you have your own land, there's a possibility that you might be able to get 100% financing. Who knows, based on what's going on with you. Easy cover loan to pay your home insurance, up to 11 months installment, plus pre-approved Visa Gold or Visa Platinum card with 5,000 bonus points. That is major. And then, of course, this special offer gives up to Barbados $2,000 off the loan application fee, up to Barbados $1,000 off your home insurance, as long as you go with the partner that's working along with CIBC First Caribbean, and up to $500 toward the valuation report. You'll need that to be able to move forward with getting your property. And it also includes discounts from some select partners as well. Did I get it right, Jerome?
Absolutely, Tisha. I absolutely perfect. We are excited to onboard some additional customers, homeowners. We want you to give us a call. You can actually call me directly at 230-2071 or email jerome.gittins@cibcfcib.com. And we are here to serve. We are here to give you the feedback that you need. And based on what I've said before in terms of, you know, persons coming out of COVID, the economy, you know, starting to pick up again, people are having a lot more confidence, and we are seeing a lot more interested persons in owning their home and also, of course, doing some home equity. This is school time. This is most of the reasons are going to university. They also want to do some sprucing up on their homes, and persons want to access that equity. So we can help you to unlock that equity that you have in your home, where you can switch your mortgage, you can have that additional financing, and we are going to make it easier because we have thought about you before we actually put this together.
Absolutely. They want you to get comfy. So make sure you go ahead and make that call. I want to thank you for coming in and sharing with us this morning. Lots to think about as we go through our day today. Thank you, Jerome. Of course, Jerome Gittins is Business Development Officer with CIBC First Caribbean International Bank, telling you all about the Get Comfy promotion. The important thing is for you to make that call. Remember, you can call him on 230-2071 or jerome.gittins@cibfcib.com. Get in there directly. Do it. Don't wait. I know you've been thinking about it for a minute. Just ask a question. I mean, what's the worst that can happen, right? Okay, we're going to take a break. When we come back, I have another question for you. Are you back to school ready? That's next.
Morning, morning, morning.
Good morning. Good morning to you.
It's summer vacation, and CBC TV 8 says, laugh a little. Your mid-mornings have now included some family-friendly, side-splitting series like The Partridge Family, Benson, and Designing Women. TV not to be missed this vacation. Weekdays from 10 a.m. on CBC TV 8. It's Match Day Live from the 246 with host Damian Best. Your all-access pass to the action happening in the BFA Premier League and beyond. Every last Monday of the month on CBC TV 8. Kickoff time, 8:30 p.m. with analysis from our panel and highlights of the top performances. You can weigh in on the discussion via WhatsApp on 228-5562. It's Match Day Live from the 246. Don't you miss it.
My friend, you don't plan to get a
morning, morning, morning.
Good morning. Good morning to you.
Children, the summer holiday is almost over, but are you back to school ready? Get back to school ready with Mornin Barbados and get a chance to win a back to school bundle, including a printer, a tablet, and headphones, just in time for the new school year. The Mornin Barbados Are You Back to School Ready promotion starts August 31st until September 13th. If you're between the ages of 8 to 15, all you have to do is tune in to Mornin Barbados and listen for when we ask, Are You Back to School Ready? Call us at 228-5562 or 228-5563. Answer three questions correctly and your name goes forward to the final draw. Remember, callers must be between the ages of 8 and 15. The winner will be announced on September 14th.
All right, I'm told there's somebody already on the phone line. Little Ariana is 8 years old. Good morning to you, Ariana.
Good morning.
Hello, I can't hear Ariana. What's going on? We have some gremlins in the studio today. Ariana.
Hi.
There you are. Good morning.
Morning.
Where are you calling me from, Ariana?
From Christchurch.
Christchurch. Where in Christchurch?
St. Patrick's.
St. Patrick's. Okay, I love St. Patrick's. I drive by there a lot. I have a question for you. Are you back to school ready?
Yes.
So you have your uniform and your shoes and your bag and your books and everything?
Yes.
Maybe a few bits and bobs to get still to, you know, for Monday. You're excited to see all your friends and meet new friends and teachers and so on?
Yes, please.
All right, my darling. It's time now for you to answer three questions. I know you're going to get them right, so that your name goes in for a chance to win. Do you know what you're getting a chance to win?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What's your favorite thing of the three? The tablet.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. All right. So here are your question. Here are your questions, rather. What do bees make?
Honey.
That's right. Now, a caterpillar turns into something beautiful. What is it?
A butterfly.
Yay! And finally, there are only two national heroes of Barbados who are still alive. Do you know their names?
Rihanna and Sir Garfield Silbert.
Yay! Absolutely. You are correct, Ariana from St. Patrick's Christchurch. Your name goes into the pool for a chance to win that tech bundle, all right? I'm happy to hear that you are back to school ready. Is there anybody you'd like to say hello to before you go?
My mommy.
Okay, what's mommy's name?
Simone.
Simone?
Mm-hmm.
Simone, you're doing a fantastic job. Congratulations, mommy, and congrats to you, Ariana. Beautiful talking to you. Have a great day today, okay?
Okay.
All right. Good stuff. So Ariana, her name goes into that pool for a chance to win. She is indeed back to school ready. All right? We're going to take a break and come on back. When we come back, we're talking Deaf Awareness Month. We have something special for you.
Morning, morning, morning.
Good morning. Good morning to you.
One's a one. It's more than a station.
We don't just play music. We keep your company, cheer you up, keep you informed and entertained. We are a vibe. What do you mean?
Every day, we bring the party to you.
We are your number one party station.
We love playing music for our listeners.
And we are committed to working with our clients and advertisers to make sure that you get the attention that you deserve.
98.1, the one.
Celebrating 18 and still your number one party station.
From the beautiful shores of the gem of the Caribbean, Barbados, home of the amazing
Mornin, Mornin.
All right, so we told you that it's Deaf Awareness Month, and we started last week teaching you a little sign language and all that wonderful stuff. So we wanted to make sure that you still have that top of mind. Now, there's a project called the Calypso Project that brought together deaf and hearing professionals from across three continents in a truly groundbreaking music and visual art project based right here in Barbados. Drawing on Calypso's vibrant histories, the activities emphasize the island's culture, as well as taking a look at deafness in on the larger scale. So coming out of that, you know, it was the intention to create some hip-hop Calypso fusion music, and we're going to share some of one of the music videos that came out of that project with you now.
Remember words,
MLK.
Now's the time,
turn the page.
That includes me,
that includes you.
This is our moment,
break on through.
Sarcasm, not a groove.
No, make it fun, make them pop, that's all we do.
Stand up. Come on, everybody, stand up. Stand up. Come on, everybody, stand up.
No bridge made of balsa.
Materials last forever.
Raise your hand.
Lend a hand.
More teachers help comprehend.
A movement, no turning back.
No more being left by the side of the road.
Everyone count, encourage and make sure undefeated glass will grow.
No excuses, it's all we'll do.
We only leap ahead by the things we do.
I said no, no excuses, it's all we'll do.
We only leap ahead by the things we do.
Stand up. Come on, everybody, stand up. Stand up. Come on, everybody, stand up. Stand up.
Courage to stand.
Courage to sit and listen.
Know it's important.
What is it?
Get it right with your visits.
Time has come today.
Came to fruition.
Gather inputs.
Making decisions.
Reaching potential.
No longer division.
Reaching our place closer than it's ever been.
Still open, all with your ideas that the road been.
Stand up. Come on, everybody, stand up. Stand up.
Hey, absolutely beautiful, wasn't it? Be sure to come on back tomorrow as you go through your Monday today. Remember to wear your smiles, do something nice for someone. Tomorrow, conversations on CARICOM. His Excellency Ambassador Commissiong will be in, and we're going to get a report on what's happening in Africa across the continent for Barbados, plus one big music exchange program, and we're talking about the Codrington Trust and United Society Partners in Global Conference. That and a whole lot more coming up tomorrow on Morning Barbados. Have a great day today. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up. Barbados, get up.
Good morning.